Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It's Francesco here. Today we will be diving into the top 10 new note-taking applications of 2021. Now this is going to be a list of applications that are more recent to the note-taking space. They are not brand new, fresh off the block, but they're neither they are old or older than say one or two years, which is the criteria for today's video. If you did want to look at a more stable and reliable applications that are on the market right now, I definitely recommend checking out our official note-taking applications list, which is here on YouTube. We'll link it in the description below. You can also skip ahead in this video if you want to check out one in particular. So let's start with number one, and that is AmpleNote. Now this is an application that is gaining a lot of attention at the moment for being a bit of a note-taking task management hub, allowing you to firstly take your notes in a very systemized fashion, taking them, capturing them, collecting them, and then organizing them, but also taking your tasks, what's called a task score, which deems whether it is too complicated or too easy to do, or how hard it will take to actually do that task. It's quite an interesting step, embedding this task management inside of a note-taking application, and it's something that's becoming much more common. Now, AmpleNote has a bit of a steeper price, and it's definitely got a little bit of a cult following behind it because a lot of people are jumping on this application and enjoying it very much. So I'll include links to AmpleNote in the description below, as well as our review on it here for Keep Productive. So number two, one that I got told off very much for not including in the main official list. The only reason I didn't is because it hasn't been out for that long, which is an app called Craft Documents. Now we've actually just released a course on this if you do want to check out that below. It's a free one. Essentially, Craft is this document application with a few, I guess, additional abilities, which makes it more of a Notion-like competitor. So essentially, you can create documents on Craft, but you can link them up using backlinks. You can create these gorgeous cards using some of the premium features inside of the application, which allows you to turn very simple elements into these really nice interactive cards, which doesn't just bode well for you using it to create some sort of like wiki system for yourself, life management, but also externally, if you're looking to share it, it definitely looks very neat, organized, and professional. So Craft is gaining a lot of attention. It's also natively built on iOS and Mac, so it's super fast and super easy to use, actually. It's gaining a lot of attention for that because obviously Notion is built more widely, whereas Craft is built what I believe is called natively, and it's gaining a lot of attention. Okay, so number three is an application called Spaces. This is available for iOS and Mac, and it's very new. It's more of a note-taking application. At a glance, it is a very simple style application. You can start writing notes, you can pin them to the top, and you can organize them in things like favorites, and you can get rid of them in archive and bin, etc. And you can use these things called Spaces to organize them into different sections, a little bit like how Bear organizes them with hashtags. Now, this is much more of a writer application, those who want to write either short form or long form writing. It's got a focus mode, which can help you narrow down on what you're writing in front of you. It uses Markdown, and it's a very much a minimalist application at the moment. Again, it's more of a Bear Notes competitor as it goes. It's very early days, but it does have the similar pricing at $14.99 per year for the Pro, which gives you access to things like sync, focus mode, and a few more theme-based features, very similar to the likes of Bear Notes. Okay, so number four is RemNote. Now, RemNote has been something that I'm meaning to eagerly review here on the channel. It's this Rome slash Notion-like application, really tailored more towards students and researchers, allowing you to connect up your notes to existing notes inside of your RemNote account, which is perfect for studying, researching, but also linking together thoughts and ideas. And they've got some really interesting development at the moment, which allows them to add lots of new features and build on the experience of linking notes. It's very early days with RemNote, but if you're looking for an application like Obsidian or Rome, but more tailored towards students, this is probably a good bet. So number five, another student type based application, which is called Supernotes. This is like a note-taking application, sort of looks like a flashcard application, but it's for collaborative note-taking, especially when you're working in groups at university, college, or you're in a study group. This is a really cool sort of application because you can link notes together. It's got a graph to help you to see the relationships between notes you're taking. So for example, if you want to build relationships based on the things you're studying, research topics, etc., this is quite a neat application for that. I would say it's a lot easier to comprehend and understand than an application like RemNote, but RemNote digs much deeper in terms of the advanced abilities, which you might enjoy if you are in the researching sort of mode. However, Supernotes is more for studying and sort of being able to take these very attractive looking cards that you can help link up and create and organize systemized topics and have parents to organize that there, as in parents. When I mean parents, I mean the organization system, not your actual parents organizing your notes. Number six is walling. This is an application I've talked about a few times now. It is this idea generation concept that basically where you capture an idea and you can help link it to existing notes inside of your walling account. And then if you want to, if it turns into a project or an idea that needs further explanation, you can turn it into a wall, and it has a board-like features to help you to expand and section out certain activities, tasks, and ideas as you're generating this idea. Now, it's got some good graph abilities, a wizard to help you connect up stuff and really dig deeper on each note you add, and a daily desk for helping you to dump stuff there, collect stuff, and organize it for later. It's quite a new concept, but I really like it. I've been talking about it for a while. We've got a review here on Keep Productive if you wanted to check it out. Okay, so Nimbus Notes, that's number seven. And this is an app that did impress me. It's got, I feel like, a really reliable sort of experience behind it. It's been around for a while, but I've included it in a new one because it's its large attention most recently. But Nimbus Notes is getting a lot of attention from Evernote users because it has some good experiences in it that are reliable and stable. I really like the way they capture emails in there. I also like some of the web and screenshot clipping abilities that they do have, but Nimbus Notes seems to be the place where Evernote users are flocking to. Now, of course, it's still early days for the application as it's growing. However, it is impressive to see a lot of Evernote users move over to this application. So number eight, we have Obsidian. This is an app I've been talking about for a while. We've actually got a course on it. That's how much I'm eager to sort of share about it. Because I think it's an application that's really gaining a lot of attention at the moment, especially because Rome Research has got this whole bidirectional links market sort of hyped up and excited, but Obsidian does a great job of replicating Rome for free, allowing you to really go deeper, take some really advanced notes, and be able to do the same sort of block referencing and link referencing inside of Obsidian that you would in Rome. So it's really gaining a lot of attention as a note taker, but also a bidirectional network thought tool that the market is hyping about at the moment. Okay, so Bundle Notes is an app that has changed quite rapidly since I checked it out originally, but you can essentially take notes on this application. It's fully marked down available, and you can create this thing called bundles. And when you create bundles, you can organize them in different layouts. For example, they have this like sort of board layout, this sort of slash spreadsheet layout, and also a few other layouts. You can organize things in tags. It's very much markdown focused, but I guess it's trying to add the simplicity of Google Keep, but the, like I guess, a tagging and organization system of some more of the deeper applications with layouts like Kanban, dark mode, sorting, and changings to layout options, which make it a little bit more interesting. Now, it's only available right now on Android and web, so it's still very early days this application, but it looks like it could be an interesting tool in the future, in beta at the moment. So number 10, I think I may have even included this in the official list, but I say it's still early days for this application in terms of that it's more recent. It's an app called Standard Notes. Standard Notes provides you with a really reliable note-taking experience that's available across all devices. It has AES-256 note encryption on it, which is pretty impressive, and privacy is the key to this application. So they've really designed this to be encryption focused, and it's probably one of the best note-taking applications for that in the space. Bare notes have some light note encryption. However, this really takes it to the next level. They even have a 5-year plan to lock you in for that long with your notes. And it does have some really nice theming that can take your account a lot further, and some editor plugins that takes, again, your account from maybe being a very basic markdown editor to something a lot further, and you can really customize that to what you want. So guys, those were the top 10 note-taking applications of 2021, and then the new ones. As you can imagine, we hoped you enjoyed today's list. If we missed any out, please do share them below. We'd love your thoughts on all of these. Which ones are you using? Which ones are you checking out in the moment? Feel free to pop them in the comments below. If you're new here, hit subscribe, and we will talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.